Hey, 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 what's good, awesome people? Welcome back to my channel, Joshua Partugi here. Glad to have you back with me again, folks. I hope you're doing well this week and keeping excited. So folks, in the last video, we learned about what a product is. If you haven't watched that video, I suggest that you watch that video first by clicking the link up here so that you can follow along with the topic we will discuss on today's video, because today's video is the continuation of that video. As we know, Scrum is a framework for developing complex products, and understanding product is the fundamental to have an effective Scrum implementation. A successful product is the one that brings outcomes both to the consumer and also to the company who develops the product. Success in Scrum is about delivering outcomes rather than delivering many outputs. But what is the difference between outcome and output? I have found that some people in some cultures think that outcome and output is the same thing. I have mentioned the notion of outcome over output several times in my past videos, and I will continue to emphasize outcome over output in my future videos. So, in today's video, we will learn what is the difference between outcome and output, and why every Scrum team should use outcome as the key success indicator for every sprint. According to the Cambridge Dictionary, output is an amount of something produced by a person, machine, factory, country, etc. while outcome is a result or effect of an action, situation, etc. We can say that output is what the Scrum team produces. The increment delivered every sprint by the Scrum team is an output. The features in that increment are considered as output also. Now, outcome is the effect that happens to our business and to our consumers after our consumers have used the features in the product. When there is outcome from the product, there should be behavioral change from the consumer. This behavioral change should be observable. For example, consumer outcome is when the consumer has ordered food from the application 10 times more frequently after the latest release. Another example, outcome is when the consumer has become more productive and has increased their monthly sales after using the features from the latest release. Both output and outcome are measurable. The number of features the Scrum team delivered every sprint, that's an output metric. The number of wireframes delivered, that's an output metric too. The number of defects found, that's an output metric too. Teams using Kanban call these metrics as throughput. So you can say that throughput is an output metric. Some teams who use story points to estimate their product backlog items, they measure velocity. So you can say that velocity is an output metric too. Teams doing waterfall and use project mindset consider project timeliness as one of the success criteria of a project. So you can say that project timeliness or project completion is an output metric. When we talk about outcomes, there are outcomes for the consumer and also outcomes for the company who develops the product. Every product has different outcome metrics because every product exists in a different context. Every product serves different consumers. Now, let's look at some examples of some outcome metrics based on the product that you're quite familiar with. For a movie streaming product, one of the consumer outcome metrics may be the frequency consumers binge watching, while one of the business outcome metrics may be the number of customers on family subscription packages. For an online healthy food delivery mobile application, one of the consumer outcome metrics may be the amount of weight lost since joining the application 3 months ago, while one of the business outcome metrics may be the total sales of foods ordered per customer in a month. For an international money transfer application, one of the consumer outcome metrics may be the increase of livability index of the consumer's parents who live in another country, while one of the business outcome metrics may be the average amount of money transferred per customer. There are so many outcome metrics. Every product has different outcome metrics. I cannot tell you all of the outcome metrics out there. It requires imagination to define all of the outcome metrics for your product. Your Scrum team needs to collaborate together with everyone in the company to define the outcome metrics that are relevant for the product you are developing. Achieving outcome metrics is not just the responsibility of a certain departments in the company or only the responsibility of the Scrum team. It's a whole company's effort. Now, here is the most interesting part. As you can probably conclude so far, output does not guarantee outcome. Just because the Scrum team completed many product backlog items, or just because their velocity or their throughput every sprint is consistently high, it does not guarantee there will be an outcome. Even though we know output does not guarantee outcome, ironically, many companies who use Scrum still measure the sprint success or the Scrum team performance using output metrics. Many companies out there still use output metrics for contract negotiation with their clients. In the past, as a YouTuber, I mainly focused on uploading as many videos as possible every month to this YouTube channel. Number of videos uploaded per month is an output metric. As I have shared with you on my previous video, from now on, I have shifted my focus towards outcome. Because I focus on outcome, I may upload videos to this channel less frequently than before. The two outcome metrics I use for this YouTube channel is the number of people who gain a better understanding about Scrum, and the number of people who can practice Scrum effectively at their workplace after watching the videos I uploaded to this channel. Bianca Vanderberg, who left a comment on this channel, told me that the videos on this channel made her switch careers to become a product owner. Now that's an outcome, folks. When we use Scrum, we should use outcome metrics as key success indicators for every sprint. The number of features delivered, or velocity, or throughput for sprint should never be used as the Scrum team success or performance or productivity indicators. The Scrum team should state the outcome metric they want to achieve in their product goal and also in their sprint goal. So, how about your Scrum team? Does your Scrum team still use output metrics like number of features or throughput or velocity or timeliness as the key success indicators? Or have they already used outcome metrics as the key success indicators? If they haven't used outcome metrics as the key success indicators, what is their obstacle? What are you going to do to challenge the status quo in your company? If they have already used outcome metrics, are there any adaptations being made after inspecting these outcome metrics? As you already know, inspection and adaptation are the foundations of Scrum. Alright, that is all from me today, folks. I hope to see more Scrum teams in the market using outcome metrics as the key success indicators. And hopefully, one of that Scrum team is your team. Thank you for watching today's video, folks. If you like today's video, go click that like button down below. See you until my next video. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, make sure you subscribe to my channel so that you will not miss any of the videos I will upload in the future. Until then, don't forget to stay awesome.